Everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling and I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental principles. When I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the listen. I've been on a mission. And I really can't take it no more. By temptations, my Lord, I'm young and I'm restless,
and I really can't help it.
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
Now everybody got fights, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice.
Brings us to the Bay Area as we welcome you to Oakland, California. The pregame festivities here in Oakland have to be seen to be believed. This crowd in silver and black, they are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Bears. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
A second down throw for Prescott. Space to maneuver at the 40. And he hits Jason Witten, the tight end. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
He's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Prescott from the gun. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. Touchdown, Cowboys! Terrence Williams, 54 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Bailey now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. Carry for Marshawn Lynch, and he'll find some space up to about the 25. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They got to feel pretty good about that one.
On second down, here's Carr. Crabtree with it over the middle. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
How about the fellas with the stars on the side of their helmets rising up on defense? We always hear about the Cowboys' rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well, I think, because they're so cohesive. Defensive line, linebackers really work well together.
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They do go for it. It's Carr. And that's complete to Walford. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Give him 12 yards that time and an Oakland first down.
I know they got the first down, but Brandon, I still don't like the call going for it there. Yeah, they got it, but I would have punted the ball there, played some field position. I mean, it's okay to end drives and kicks, right? You know, we've heard that.
Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. And before this series gets rolling, you know, a story, very feel-good story. Cowboys' third preseason game. Nice to see Jalen Smith out there, wasn't it?
I almost get emotional talking about this because when Jalen Smith was in college at Notre Dame before that draft season, I had him ranked as a top player in college football. And when I saw him get hurt in the bowl game and then to hear the extent of the injury where people said he may never play.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, we've got a second. Want to take a quick spin around the league. Get your thoughts on the rookie quarterbacks. Some of them have been playing really well early, haven't they?
Yeah, so much for guys needing time to develop, or so it appears, right? Mitchell Trubisky in Chicago, Deshaun Watson in Houston. All of them have played pretty well here in the early going in the preseason. And in a couple of cases, they pushed their starting quarterbacks to become better, right? Tom Savage has picked up his game in Houston, as has Alex Smith in Kansas City. And one other rookie, keep an eye on DeShone Kizer in Cleveland. I think he's on the rise.
On play action, it's Carr. That's Cordarrelle Patterson hauling it in. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. Carr finding Patterson there for a Raider first. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First down, the run with Lynch. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 more yards there and another first down.
So right now what I'm seeing an offense is just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of contact.
Carr now on first down. Got it complete to Crabtree. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. And the offense lining up first and 10. They go play action here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. On second down, Lynch. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Third and 11, and some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. Throwing his car on third down. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
And he's going to miss this one. That is no good. Well outside the left upright. And this score will stay right where it is. Well, now they'll start 3 yards shy of midfield after that long 57-yard miss. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Going deep here for Bryant. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
On second down, Elliott. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up 3rd and 9.
Watch that in.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. He's got his man. It's Williams. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A very solid gain of 27. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
So when you call a corner blitz, what a lot of teams call a cat blitz, you're expected to come after the quarterback. But in this case, he ran into the ball carrier. Really nice technique, because what you do is you come deep as the deepest offensive player so he can't get outside of you.
They go to Elliott again. Heck of a broken tackle, but only able to work this down near the 23. 2 yards gets them back to where they started, but now third and 10.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. On third down, it's Prescott. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact. Able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free. Because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the lead moves to 10-0. So it's a 7-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that worked, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. So out come the Raiders. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. Down. And that's complete. It's the Carr to Cooper connection. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Two minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. Throwing on first down is Carr. And complete, right side to Cook. They're calling a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm, this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, second down.
No gain on that run, and while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving.
And he's going to be taken down, back around the 35-yard line. Taco Charlton in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a 3rd and long. From the gun, it's Carr. He's going to let this one go. Man, it's caught inside the 10. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run with Lynch, and they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Give him 3 on the gain there, second and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
They try again with Lynch. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. And now here come the Cowboys. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Second down, Prescott. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. The Cowboys on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Final play of the half, Prescott. Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Time for a break. And apparently that's all, Larry. So much for the halftime report. We'll see you in the postgame. We're ready to get to the third quarter. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. Out comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number 3. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half 2, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Shotgun now for Carr. Got some real estate inside the 30. Over the middle, it's Jared Cook. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Solid gain of 18 and a Raider first down. Defense showing blitz. On first down, Carr. And this is caught. Crabtree, touchdown Raiders. Michael Crabtree, a 24-yard touchdown. And the Raiders are able to cash in for 6. And that makes it 14-10. Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards, they just declined it.
And I have to think that the official is thinking to himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? all I can think of is that someone on the field got confused. It had to, because you're going to take the yards on that penalty each and every time.
And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Obi Melifonwu. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought? That had to be. Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked off that pass?
The free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does.
And the ball is knocked out, and the Raiders pick it up. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than it.
And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Jared Cook from 17 yards out. And the forced fumble defensively leads to 6 points for the Raiders. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he is out of bounds here on the return. And this will get out of bounds. No worries there, though. That still goes as a touchback. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you? And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Obi Melifonwu. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
They start the drive with Lynch. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. On play action, now Carr. Open man there is Patterson, complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion. Now a play fake here on first down. And this is caught by Cooper for a Raider touchdown. Amari Cooper from 19 yards away. And the Raiders add 6 to their lead. That's one of those touchdown tosses where if it's an inch to the right or left, it's not a touchdown. He had to put it right on the money.
Yeah, and how did he do that? Everything around him, everything swirling, all the coverage downfield. Somehow he spotted the opening and put it right there.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's got Rome. And he'll weave his way up, all the way up, a few yards shy of midfield.
We all know the teams never want to use the word panic. But if they expect to win this game, it has to start right here, right now. That return just set them up for points, and it needs to be a touchdown, not a field goal.
They'll start the drive with Elliott, and he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Looking to throw. Prescott. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Well, the screen gets 7, but it's not enough, and it'll be 4th down.
They dialed up the screen pass on 3rd down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a 1st down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
He completes it to Bryant. Touchdown, Cowboys! Dez Bryant, 45 yards. And the Cowboys get a bit closer. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And now here come the Raiders. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. Back now in the East Bay. Throwing on 2nd down. His throw incomplete. Crabtree, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Play action. Now it's Carr. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys.
But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the one-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Out of his end zone, Prescott is going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's only able to get it to right around the three. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll make it a second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Prescott now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
A lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. The Cowboys on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Prescott from the gun. Got a man, it's complete. Williams. And he's going to have the first down as he's marked down just shy of the 20. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Shift together here from the D-line. Prescott. That's caught by Butler over the middle. 30, 10, 5, touchdown, Cowboys. Bryce Butler, 81 yards, and the Cowboys cut into that lead.
Partner, you know what the real key is to stopping a good passing attack?
You tell me.
Being able to tackle as soon as a guy catches a football.
Didn't work out there.
No, because when you give up the big run after catch, the rack yardage, that puts your defense in a big-time stressful position.
A lot of rack yardage and a touchdown there on the big play. Bailey now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. The Raider offense now making their way toward the huddle. Now, the previous drive they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the 4 fingers. Fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the 4 fingers for 4-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind.
And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Stephen Paya busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a 3rd and long. Here's Carr. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. On is the punter, King, to send it away. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are. But with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Looking downfield for Dez, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. Third down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Prescott from the gun on third. Over the middle, complete. It's Butler. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. A first down throw for Prescott. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked up by Gary and Conley. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games. And now in this situation here, when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
They'll run it now out of the gun. He'll wind up getting 4 down to the 36. 6 yards to go here on second down. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. Here comes the D swarming to the line. Carr to throw on second down. He'll check this down to Lynch, complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Marshawn Lynch, 36 yards. And a forced fumble defensively leads to 6 points for the Raiders. And this one through the uprights and good. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Here comes Ryan Switzer to return it. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's
make
get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
Throwing. Prescott. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A gain of 32 that time. Prescott on first down. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic, and people wanting to put a little contact on him. Really well done.
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack.
Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And his throw here's incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. And it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Third and long for Prescott. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. And now before they run this fourth down play, we're going to get a timeout, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They'll start on the ground with Lynch. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Carr gonna look to throw. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A good pickup there, a 22. And we're hitting the end of this one, and it looks to probably be the final play.
I stay myself, I never change, yeah.